after praising the King of all kings, the Master of the Day of Judgment, the One, the Only, Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty, and sending salutations on the Imam of the Prophets, Leader of the Prophets, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Recently, I had a meeting. Few brothers came along and they start talking ill about Mufti Menk. Many of you who do not know who Mufti Menk is, I'll tell you who he is. He is a man from amongst the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Allah the Almighty has accepted. For that reason, Allah the Almighty has used him to spread the deen. Millions of people from all around the globe listen to his lectures and they benefit. So they told me that we don't like Mufti Menk. We want you to refute him. We'll give you so and so. All you need to do is speak against him. Wallahi, I have no beef with Mufti Menk. So I switched on them. I said, tell me, what time's Fajr? Man didn't know what time Fajr was. So I said, what time is Dhuhr? He gave me the wrong time. They don't pray. And then they've got this nasty habit going around to individuals and imams. Go refute this imam. We think he's corrupted. Wallahi, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, and I got news for you. Those who slander and backbite, you will pay the price in this world and in the next. Why? Because the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, backbiting and slandering cuts away the iman just as a shepherd knocks a leaf off a tree. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there will be people in the fire of Jahannam, in the fire of hell, and they will be irritated by a group of people. And who are this group of people? They will be those individuals who used to slander and backbite. Slandering and backbiting, room mongering, you will definitely will be disgraced in this world and the Akhirah. And this is a habit of many going around slandering and backbiting the imams. They think the imams are superheroes. They think the imams can't commit sin. But we have a Allah. The Lord the Almighty will forgive. The people committed sin. The number, the sand in the desert. You return to Allah Azza wa Jalla the Mighty and ask Him for forgiveness. Allah will wipe your slate clean. How many times we hear man and them and gal and them will sit in circles and they will pick a topic of a week. Yes, let's slander Mufti Menk. Today is a day. Let's slander Nu'man Ali Khan. Today is a day. Let's slander Muhammad Abdul Jabbar. Man's going around having circles, meetings, slandering imams, slandering people who Allah accepted for the service of His religion. How are you going to stand on the plane of resurrection on the day of judgment when you slander and backbite, when you're going around making YouTube videos on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, spreading lies and slanders against imams? How are you going to stand on the plane of resurrection in front of the Lord of the universe, Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Mighty? Fear Allah, fear Allah, fear Allah. And if you don't fear Allah, then I got news for you. Then wait for the punishment of Allah Azza wa Jalla to descend.